guys, Laura here. I'm here today to do a review of Lindsay Miller's Mask of Shadows. This book for free from NetGalley, so thank you NetGalley and the publisher and Lindsay Miller. Overall, I really like this book. I gave this book 4 stars. I will admit, I don't read a lot of fantasy books over the summer because it's just, I like to read quick reads. So I wish I would have waited until September to read this because I think it would have had my attention a little bit more. But I really liked it. The highlight of this novel was the main character, Sal, or Salon, I think you call her. She's a gender fluid character. And I really love when you see LGBTQ or gender fluid characters in other, like in fantasy novels or in dystopian novels or in anything where the focus isn't necessarily on their journey, because I think in a society that really does a lot of like very, very focused storytelling, it sometimes is good just to read a fantasy novel and see a character like that, because it reminds you that we're all alike. And I just thought it was so well done. That was like the highlight, just the way the world was crafted, but also how that character was crafted. And I just really was impressed by it. It had a lot of like Thorn of Glass vibes to it. A lot of Thorns of Glass vibe, very, very similar to Thorn of Glass. There's some other questioning things that I predict will come up in book 2 and 3. But it's basically about this character who's a thief, and she winds up making the decision after the Hand of the Queen, and they're named after the 5 jewels, is murdered. There is a a trial to see who's going to become the Opal, and she makes the decision to join this process, and they're taught how to be assassins, but then they have to kill their competitors. So it's very, very well done. A lot, very, very blood, very, very gory, but there's also like the hint of like a love interest in there, and then there's also like a political game that's being played. And then there's also, like, a magical component. Magic does not exist in this society because at the start of the story, you learn why. So that was very, very well done. I will admit that the way that the assassins are named, they're given numbers. And that made it very hard for me to connect to the characters because I would forget what number went with what character. And I was having a problem remembering like what character was killed and what character was still alive. I know they couldn't have names because they have masks and you can't see anyone. So you just have the number on their mask. So I'm hopeful in book 2, the characterization will become a little bit clearer and maybe I'll like the characters that we meet. The ending I felt was a little bit rushed as well, and I will probably need to reread the ending before I read book 2. But overall, it was really, really fun read story. I just loved the gender fluid character, and I also loved all the characters that we met. I really loved the character of Maud. I just wish we would have known the competitors a little bit as well. And I love the dynamics between the queen and the lead character because I thought that it was so well done and it really like impressed me. So overall, I really liked Mask of Shadows. I gave it 4 stars. If you're looking for kind of a read like Thorn of Glass, I would recommend it. I thought it was very, very well done. But the highlight of this was the integration of LGBTQ characters in it, and I really just was impressed by it. So I hope you guys will consider checking it out, and I'll talk to you guys later. Bye!